Yaskawa.
Continuing in the series on what's new with MotionWorks IEC 3, I will be talking about the VIPA SLIO system integration. Hi, I am Micah Stiedemann. I'm going to start by giving a small overview of the VIPA system, then I will show how to configure the VIPA system so it can be used by the MPIC controller. The VIPA SLIO system is a slice I/O system which allows the motion controller to have access to the external inputs and outputs. The design is very simple, so no tools are needed to install it on a DIN rail mount. Each interface module can support up to 64 I/O modules. Each slice shows the status of its input or output terminals along with its connection to the interface module. The interface module can transfer data between itself and the other modules at 48 megabits per second. The response time between the I/O module and the interface module can be as low as 20 microseconds. There are over 70 options available for the VIPA SLIO system. Currently, MotionWorks IEC supports the Ethernet IP interface module, all of the 24-volt power modules, and all of the digital and analog input and output modules. The VIPA interface module also has a web interface that can be used for performing diagnostics, checking module statuses, and configuring the VIPA SLIO system. So now let's look at a configuration example. Set up, I have an MP23S IEC motion controller, a MotionWorks IEC PC, and a VIPA SLIO system connected all by a network switch. The VIPA SLIO system is made up of an interface module, a 10-amp 24-volt power slice, a 4-output digital output slice, and a 4-input digital input slice. The interface module transfers the data between the controller and the input and output modules, which are also known as slices. First, I will configure the VIPA SLIO system using the web server. Then I will open MotionWorks IEC 3 hardware configuration and add the VIPA system as an Ethernet IP adapter. And then I will perform an online save and reboot. After this is done, the I/O connections can then be checked. The VIPA IP address is needed to connect to the web server to initially configure the VIPA system. Out of the box, the VIPA interface module is set to 192.168.1.1. For information on setting the VIPA's IP address, please go to yaskawa.com/SLIO. And under the interface tab, select View Supporting Documents to find the interface module's manual. For this example, the VIPA system's IP address is set to 192.168.15.230. So I'm going to put that into my web browser here and press Enter. When the web server appears, I can go into the Configuration tab and click on the Save. This configures the interface module to know that two slice I/O cards are attached to the device. This needs to be performed every time you add or remove a slice from the SLIO system. So now let's go into MotionWorks IEC 3 and open the hardware configuration. In hardware configuration, I'm going to go online with the controller, and then I'm going to go down to the Ethernet IP settings, right-click, and select Add Device. In here, you can see that we have the VIPA SLIO actually set up as a separate device for Ethernet IP. So we are going to click on that and select Finish. First, I'm going to set the IP address, that is the IP address of the actual VIPA SLIO system. For me, it will be 192.168.15.230. And then I want to make sure that I set this to either the medium or the slow task, because there is a limit to the task speed that is supported by VIPA. You have the choice of changing the name, I/O group label, and the status variable. I'm just going to leave them set to default. So I am going to hit OK. You can see that I have the VIPA SLIO system set up as an adapter. So I'm going to select the VIPA device in the hardware tree. This opens up the configuration menu for the VIPA SLIO system. There are multiple ways you can add modules. One of the ways is to go over to the module catalog and drag one of the modules into the VIPA SLIO graphic. So I'm going to select the DI4X DC 24-volt card and drag it into the open slot in the VIPA SLIO graphic. Now it is added to the VIPA system. Another way this can be done is to go over and select the module and then press the Add Slice button. This will then add the slice into the selected location. Now for my system right here, I do not need an analog input or output. But let's say for instance that I would like to add an analog output. So let me go into the module catalog and grab the AO4X 16-bit unsigned module and place it at the end. Now you can see that when I added the module, it turned orange. Hardware configuration is saying that it cannot put that module there because it cannot set up the bus address incorrectly. One way to make the analog slice work in the system is to move the digital output card after the analog output card. This fixes the bus addressing issue. Since the analog output card is not needed, let's remove it by clicking the Delete Slice button. Up here, we have the update interval, which refers to the task time that was chosen when the VIPA device was set up as an Ethernet IP adapter. You also have this load factor up here. This is used to estimate how much power will be coming through the front plane of the VIPA system. Information on how to use this can be found in the Help menu under Contents, MotionWorks IEC Hardware Configuration, Ethernet Communication, Adding a VIPA SLIO. Since I have communication to the VIPA from my PC, I can use the Get Online Configuration button, which pulls in the attached I/O information. After the VIPA configuration is set, an online save and reboot can be performed. When the controller finishes rebooting, you can go to the global variable list and see that we now have a variable for both our input and output cards. So now we can test our inputs and outputs. I will have to make, download, and then perform a warm or cold start. Now I can turn on the debugging mode. To test the inputs and outputs, I will set digital output 0 equal to true. Since I have digital output 0 wired to digital input 0 of the VIPA SLIO system, digital input 0 will turn on. This verifies that the system is working and the motion controller can talk with the VIPA SLIO system. Thank you for watching this video. Support information can be found at yaskawa.com/SLIO.